Hi everyone, welcome to Diana's Table. Today we have a very, very special treat for you. We are here in Icheon, which is known for Korean ceramics. And we're going to be visiting with a very close friend and a famous ceramic artist named Lee Jeongmee. And so we are here at her studio. So let's go and meet her. Come on. 아, 안녕하세요. 아이고, 이렇게 더운데 너무 감사합니다. 이렇게 좀 들어가서. 와우. Look at this. Look at all of her pieces here. 조금 설명을 좀 해주실래요? 이게 어떤 작품들인지?
백자에 보면
the white ceramic is what she first started with and is based on very traditional Korean ceramic. But she actually took the tradition and made it her own by emphasizing the stroke of the clay and also taking motivation from traditional Korean letters, alphabets, or shapes. As you can see, she goes from white to this mint green, and it almost like looks like an impressionist painting. She actually takes these little gradation and the little differences in thickness to her advantage by showing it as it is. And she says that she chose this mint before she goes from white to the next stage, which is blue. And it reflects the Korean tradition, and yet at the same time she has her modern touches to it. This is actually a ceramic, I guess, sculptor representing Korean woman. Usually when a Korean woman gets married, the first hanbok, the traditional garment that we wear green blouse and red skirt. That shows that you're newlywed. And she actually started to make this ceramic based on this first woman entrepreneur out of Jeju Island named Kim Mandok. She was a very famous entrepreneur. She made lots of money and she actually gave it all back to help people in her community. So she wanted to represent that Kim Mandok's spirit and also the strength of Korean women through her piece. And in order to do so, instead of taking her usual approach to ceramics as a painting, she actually applied lacquer here, which makes the colors really set in a very clean and non-fading way, so that what we call 단색 is like one color, monotone, monochromatic feel to it. It's very interesting. In ceramic, you dry it through heat, but when you apply lacquer, you actually have to have 80% humidity, steam, to dry it properly so that the colors will set. So I think this is really beautiful piece. So this is a variation of her Blue Moon series, which is flat, but she made it a little more three-dimensional. And you can use it both ways. You can use it flat, or you can use it like a bowl. But it's one thing that's really interesting about this is that you can see the pattern inside. It's almost like Jackson Pollock piece. So with her, every piece is a creative process, and she tries to not only do ceramics, but through ceramics, she expresses different forms of her art through lacquer, through color variations, through variations in thickness and pattern.
다랑아리를 해도 기존의
Traditionally in Korea, when you look at the moon jar, it's expressed in basically all white, and the shape is really perfectly round to represent full moon. But with her, she chose to represent a moon that is a little bit less than perfectly round because moon is always changing its shape. And she loves Beethoven's Moonlight Sonata. So she wanted to also express the light portion of the moon. So she used the painting to show the sort of the glowing moonlight in this jar. And in this, you can also see on the mouth of the jar, she shows a little bit of fingerprint of her work, because she wants to show that it's a very natural formation made with clay. And so she really maximizes the natural characteristics to show that it's a circle in process, moon in process, and the light itself is translucent. And so it almost looks like a moon that's sort of, you know, rotating as well.
Wow, 이건 또 뭔가요?
이게 바로 그 가마예요. 그래서 이게 지금 다른
This is the kiln that she makes her ceramic pieces, and she actually stacks everything up here, and she pushes it in because with her request, private request, they made wheels on it so she could pull in and out to make it easy. And these bricks would stand up to 1,300 degrees in heat. So actually they used to use this brick to melt steel. So you can, and it's really heavy. I mean, I really don't know how she can do this without wheels.